Hello students, welcome to the class. In the previous class, hey students, you know we have discussed about the introduction to the continuous function, the definition of the continuous function, okay? And here we are going to discuss a problem over the concept over the continuous function, okay? So here is the problem in front of you. Here we are going to discuss over that, and let us see the question. So that the function fx given by fx is equal to sin x by x plus cos x when x is not equal to 0. 2, fx is equal to 2 when x is equal to 0 is continuous at x is equal to 0. Okay, understand? So that the function fx is given by fx is equal to sin x by x plus cos x when x is not equal to 0. Again, fx is equal to 2 when x is equal to 0 is continuous at x is equal to 0. Okay, understand all of you? And we know according to the definition of continuous function, according to the definition of continuous function, that a function is said to be a continuous function at the point x is equal to 0 if limiting value of the function, limit of the function, the limiting value of the function, limit of fx at x approaches 0 is equal to functional value. Is equal to functional value at x is equal to 0. If limit of fx, x approaches 0 is equal to f0. We can prove. Understand or not? Achha, limit of fx, you see, since x is not equal to 0, so you are finding, we are going to find out the limit of the function at the two point. One is the left hand limit and other is the right hand limit. We have to look that right hand limit. You have to show first where the function limit of the function exists. So in order to prove that, we have to see whether the left hand limit is equal to right hand limit. Okay, let us see left hand limit. So first you find out the left hand limit. Okay, so first here you discuss LHS, left hand side. Left hand side means we have to find out the limit fx at x approaches 0. For that you have to prove left hand limit. Okay, left hand limit means limit x approaches 0 minus f of x. Okay, using the h method of the limit, the limit you can write h approaches 0 f of 0 minus h, 0 minus h, that is equal to limit h approaches 0 f of minus h. Okay, and that is equal to limit h approaches 0 f of minus h means what is when x. Okay, then you have to write the sin x by x plus cos x. Right? So, limit h approaches 0. Here, what is the domain of the function? Minus h. So, put in place of x is minus h. Sin of minus h by minus h plus cos of minus s. Okay, and that is equal to limit of h approaches 0 sine of minus s. All of you know sine of minus theta is equal to minus sine theta. and its related formula is that cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta. Yes or no? So let us write the limit sine of minus h. I can write minus sine h. Okay, since sine minus theta is equal to minus sine theta is equal to minus h plus cos of minus theta is equal to cos h. Cos h. Understand? Here is minus h. Okay, so this minus sine we can cancel. After that, the limit h approaches 0. Sine h by h, sine limit of sine h by h plus limit of cos h when h approaches 0. Okay, you remove the bracket. Here we have removed the bracket, and all of you know the limit sine h by h value is what? 1. And cos h approaches 0, in place of h we can write cos 0. You write cos 0. So 1 plus cos 0 value 1. So 1 plus 1 2. Hence we got left hand limit is equal to 2. This is the left hand limit we got. Okay, understand? Is it clear? Okay, note down. Noted? Okay. Achha, let us come to the right hand limit. This is left hand limit where is equal to. Let us discuss right hand limit. So what is right hand limit? Right hand limit. What is right hand limit? Right hand limit. In right hand limit what? Limit x approaches 0 plus f of x, and that is equal to limit using h method, h approaches 0, f of what? 0 plus h, and that is equal to limit h approaches 0, f of h. Okay, then that's equal to limit h approaches 0, f of h, what is function fx? Fx is given sine x by x plus cos x. Okay, and that is equal to limit h approaches 0, sine h by h plus, we can remove the bracket, h approaches 0, cos h. Okay, here, you know the limit sine h by h approaches 0 is 1, this value. Okay, plus, if you see, limit h sine h by h approaches 0 is 1, plus, and if you put in cos in place of h 0, so cos 0, 1 plus cos 0 value 1, that is equal to 2. Hence, your right hand limit is also equal to 2. You see now? See now? So, left hand limits, since left hand limit is equal to right hand limit, hence, limit fx when x approaches 0 exist. So limiting function is exist. This is point 3. First point LHS we prove. Okay, limit of the function x approaches 0 is exist. Clear? Clear? Understand? Okay. Note down. So thus we get the limit of the function exist. Since the limiting value left hand limit is equal to right hand limit. Clear? And the second point, RHS. So is that RH is functional value? RH is f of 0. When x is equal to 0, what is the value of the function? Okay, at x is equal to 0. Understand? At x is equal to 0, will be clear. You see now f of 0. What is that given? 2 given. Hence, f of 0 is 2. X is 0, 2. And limit of fx, x approaches 0 is also equal to 2. Because left hand limit is equal to 2, right hand limit is equal to 2, it means limit of the function x approaches 0 is also 2. So from this we will understand. Okay, so hence we got limit fx, x approaches 0 is equal to functional value. So limiting value is equal to functional value. Thus, it is proved that f is a continuous function at x is equal to 2. Okay, this is the answer. This is proof. We prove it one. Okay, clear? So let us practice this. I hope you have understood. Okay, all the best. See you next. Thank you.